Episode 6 of Hell of a Boss just dropped, and not only was it probably the most entertaining episode so far, but they gave us some very subtle clues about what is to come, including the possibility that the secret agents may be working with the cherubs. My name is Deepcut, welcome back to Cartoon Universe, and let's talk about everything we learned from Episode 6 of Hell of a Boss, Truth Seekers. We have like 6 more videos coming out based off of this episode at the very least, so make sure you hit that subscribe button so you don't miss any of them. Now, this episode had a pretty straightforward plot. It opens with the previous shenanigans of the Imp Gang being watched on several screens before revealing 2 secret agents, simply referred to as Agent 1 and Agent 2 in the credits. They have come to understand that the Imp Gang are demons who are sent out on kill missions, but are unsure how to predict where they will strike next, making it hard to capture them. At this time, the Imp Gang just so happens to be finishing up a mission in the alley, and the agents are able to capture Moxie and Blitz. The two work through some of their emotional issues thanks to a drug trip the secret agents put them through, and the episode ends with the entire Imp Gang escaping when Stolas comes to save them. From the very beginning, something seemed off about this setup. While it was presented purely as part of the show's trademark humor, that Blitz just so happened to be finishing an assassination while the secret agents were trying to figure out how they would ever capture him, I think it isn't a coincidence at all. When looking at the monitors in the background, I spent a lot of time trying to find any indication of the cherubs from episode 4. The footage they have of the Imp Gang comes from across almost every episode, including the episode the cherubs are in. They even have some shots that take place in scenes where the cherubs were talking to the imps, but we never actually see the cherubs themselves. On top of that, the agents never even bring the cherubs up. While it is possible that the imps just so happen to appear on all of these hidden cameras but not the cherubs, I think the more likely answer is that the cherubs have magic powers that make them invisible to cameras. Demons, we can say for certain, do not have this power. As we explored in episode 3, they are required to have human disguises by Hell's laws whenever they are up on Earth. The cherubs, on the other hand, had no disguises, and yet seemed unworried about appearing before dozens of humans throughout the episode. We can rationalize that the dumb humans all fell for the imps' disguises, but I doubt they saw a floating goat and thought it was just some ordinary occurrence. I think the angels were able to act so confidently without disguises because they knew that no humans would see them unless they wanted the humans to see them. Now, this part might sound crazy, but this gives me reason to believe that the cherubs may have helped the secret agents in this episode. At the end of episode 4, the cherubs were kicked out of heaven, so we don't know where they might have gone. After so many people were slaughtered, there was likely an investigation at the theater, and at some point, the Truth Seekers government agents would have been brought in. I'm thinking that the cherubs probably observed that these agents have been following the Imp Gang for a while and wanted to use that to their advantage. Whoever the Imp Gang was sent to assassinate in this episode could have been a random person that the cherubs chose just to lure the Imp Gang near the secret agents. If TV commercials from heaven can make it to hell, then there is no reason to think that they wouldn't have some sort of angelic phone that they could place a call from. After all, Blitz's own hell phone works on Earth. They could have called pretending to be sinners putting out a hit on a human who just so happened to be next door to these secret agents. Now that the plan has failed though and the Imp Gang got away, I think it's possible that the cherubs will reveal themselves to the secret agents, so they can work more hands-on in a way to capture the Imp Gang and get them stuck on Earth, just like the cherubs are. It would be the best revenge a cherub could get, I think, and it certainly isn't the last we should be seeing of the secret agents at the Department of Dorks. Despite their lack of official names, they have similar energy to the cherubs, Verossica and Stryker. They're written like people who we're going to get to know as the series progresses, and I can't wait for that, because as much as I love all these demonic characters, it would be cool to see some interesting development with some humans. And of course, they just set up their return thanks to Stolas not destroying all of the camera footage of the Imp Gang. I'm not sure why he didn't do this. He seems to turn his head here and shut the cameras off. You would think he would have used his crazy awesome demon energy to absolutely destroy the entire facility so no evidence was left behind, or at least crash the computers. Regardless, this guarantees we'll be seeing more conflict between the humans and demons going forward, something we should have seen coming from the original pilot when Blitz, Millie, and Moxie managed to get themselves on the evening news when dropping off a body back on Earth. Now, we've got plenty more to talk about, but real quick, I just thought I'd take the time to invite all of you to the Cartoon Universe Discord server. It's just a place to talk about all sorts of cartoons, including Hazbin Hotel and Hell of a Boss. I'll put a link to it in a pinned comment down below, and what the hell, I'll include the link to my personal Hazbin server, where we're working on our Hazbin Hotel lore site, as well as our Twitter handles for Cartoon Universe and its hosts. Come follow us and have a chat about the show. Getting back to Stolas, we actually got some really interesting insight into his character, powers, and abilities in this episode. According to VisiPop, all demons are capable of transforming into something of a full demon mode, something we will get little hints of here and there, such as Charlie turning to something beastly for a split second in the Hazbin Hotel pilot, or Katie Killjoy in a silhouette. In a similar fashion, we saw Stolas become a hard-to-see monstrous demon when he first manifests on Earth. It is hard to say if the darkness is entirely because of mood lighting, or if Stolas would look similar in perfect daylight as well when taking this form, but it's a cool look at this power that gets only hinted at here and there in the story. How he manifested it in the agency was also really awesome, and it explains quite a bit about why Stolas can get away with lending out the grimoire. He couldn't create a portal directly to the human world without it, but he was able to use different magic to possess dead bodies. He then made them perform a ritual to summon Stolas specifically, something described in the real-life Lesser Key of Solomon that Stolas and his grimoire are inspired by. He basically used a spell that humans use to force Stolas into the human world to get there of his own free will. He likely uses similar hacks and cheat codes to get other stuff done in between his absolute need for the book on the full moon each month. Finally, before we go, let's talk about the absolute lack of Asmodeus and the Lust Ring in this episode. Many fans, myself included, thought this episode would be all about the Lust Ring, as the few remaining scenes in the trailer from this season seemed to be tied together narratively, giving the impression that they were all in one episode, including these epic shots that show Stolas in the Lust Ring and this strange figure on a stage. This strange figure has three neon faces, including a man, a sheep, and a bull, which happens to be the three heads that the demon Asmodeus is described as having in real-life Christian writings. Asmodeus, of course, is listed in the Peter Binsfield classification of demons as the Prince of Lust, which indicates that this may be our first real look at one of the seven deadly princes. We managed to see a silhouette of Lucifer in the pilot, as well as seeing a portrait of him in the hotel, and Mammon was depicted on the currency we saw in the Greed Ring, but this would have been our first real look at one of the seven princes in person. So it makes sense that this is being saved for either episode 7 or more likely episode 8, which is the season finale. Now, I also have a lot to say about the awesome dream sequences Blitz and Moxie had and what they say for the future of the show, its lore, and its characters, but not enough time to break it down in this video. So hit that subscribe button so you don't miss it when I get the video out either tomorrow or the next day, and if you still need more Hell of a Boss and Hazbin theories in the meantime, consider signing up for our Patreon. For $1 a month, you get a theory like this each week, with even more theories at higher tiers with all sorts of perks. I'll include the info in the description down below, and I'll see you next time.